learning how to love and do it is my highest purpose in life.
Hello, lovely people.
For those who don't know me, I'm Michał Kaligrix
from Tantra Movement. So now I would like to share with you my stream of thoughts on different subjects. I would like to continue the experiment of sharing my thoughts. Maybe it would be this time great channeling on interesting subjects, and then from this chaos maybe some beautiful insights would come to me and to you. Let's see. So I was just thinking, so I continue. Sometimes it's maybe good to be single, to be apart from anyone, and to just reflect your thoughts, to go into yourself inside. But yes, it's not the most efficient way I experienced in my life. In my life I experienced that what makes you most grow, healing, liberating, expanding in love, expanding in ecstasy, it's being in conscious relationship. And yes, conscious relationship is about mirroring each other and seeing, being triggered by some of the things, going into the connection so deep that yes, we take away all the protections, all the masks what we used to put on ourselves just before we go out from our homes. So in our partner, our long time relationship partner, we are going so deep into that connection that we remove all these masks, and then we can show ourselves completely, truly, and we remove all our protections, and then we are triggered. Yes, usually we are attracted in the conscious relationships with the partner who would trigger us with the who would touch us where is the most painful. What and that's all in order for us to heal those wounds what are there deeply under protections, and yes, because we love that person so much, we are able to bite our unhealthy ego and choose from love this time, not from fear, choose from love, not from anger, but rise above this. And yes, when there is anger, when there is fear or other emotions, is this just releasing some old anger, some old issue, in order to heal, to realize that hey, actually yes, I can always choose love afterwards. Yes, we go through the processes in conscious relationship of releasing a lot of issues and so, but the love always guides us and brings us back together, and that's how we grow through all those issues. But in the end we're learning how to choose the love instead of the conditionings what yes are conditioned on us. So yes, to choose out of fear, out of overprotecting ourselves, out of anxiety that something may happen. But when we trust, when we love, we see after a while, one second time situation repeat itself. If we are conscious about it, then we can just grow through it in some moment and release all the patterns what are old and doesn't fit us anymore. So with love, with conscious relationship, we grow. So that's why I'm asking, yes, if you are in Tantra and if you are not in conscious relationship, why are you wasting your time, why are you wasting your life in conscious relationship intensify, like Tantra is about intensify your life, to live your life, to get into so-called whatever enlightenment, whatever unconditional love, happiness, in to create heaven on earth here and now, not in the next life. So yes, from my experience, thankful the conscious relationship, you may intensify that process. So that's why I see very connected part to Tantra is being in the conscious relationship and going together through the processes and going deep, not changing the partners as soon the difficulties arise, but growing through those difficulties and every challenge we say in Tantra is bigger challenge than is bigger growth. So growing through those challenges, and then of course I'm not saying here to stay as many people do in the Catholic marriages or whatever, stay unhappy and because that's how the society make them to stay. The family would put cross on them and the society put cross on them. So they stay unhappy, sometimes in sake for raising the children, sometimes in sake of having good reputation in the family, or they don't see that this is blind way. So I'm not talking here about staying unhappy and keep bleeding, hitting the wall the same, going through the same issue again and again, and keep bleeding, keep hurting each other through all life, or staying stagnated in the relationship. And so no, conscious relationship, it grows through the issues. It maybe sometimes it's fiery and so, but it's grows. Maybe in your conscious relationship after years, maybe after some time, you may realize, okay, there is some issue what we as a relationship cannot go through. You tried everything, you asked therapists, you went through any solutions possible, and you don't see any solution. The situation just repeat itself constantly. And so that's maybe the moment, okay, you reach the potential of this relationship, and that's it's time to move on, to not to stay hitting with your forehead the wall and keep bleeding and keep hitting. But if you didn't tried all the solutions, and so it's worth it to find the solutions, to go through the solutions and to grow through the issues what you are facing. Because if you run away from it, like many people does by changing the relationship very quickly, you would face the same issue in the next conscious relationship. And some people repeating the same issue through all their lives with the next partner and the next partner and the next partner. And yes, how long you want to stay on that level. So yes, it's really better, nicer that you find the solution, you look for the solution. That's what also is conscious relationships are about, that you keep searching, that you keep growing, that there is no straight road from A to Z, but sometimes you have to try this, sometimes you have to try that, sometimes you have to ask people for help, sometimes you have to find the help, and so on and so on, and try the things what maybe are the most challenging for you, most crazy, most unbelievable things what may work. You have to just do it and see, oh, actually does work. But you know, like, yeah, you have to do things sometimes out of your comfort zone. You have to stop repeating the same behavior, the same mistake, the same thing. If you see that the pattern is repeating itself from one relationship to another relationship, you see this repetition, it's a sign for you, hey, you have to change something. Otherwise, it's like Einstein said, madness, repeating the same thing over and over again and expecting the other result. No, the result would be the same. You would repeat the same thing in the next relationship. Maybe you would have a little bit of nice moment of freshness, of honeymoon and so, but you would never be able to experience the depth, what is behind this, what you didn't grow it yet into. So yes, this is what it's actually, what conscious relationship have advantage of above the, unconscious relationship, that as deeper you go through the challenges, as more aware you are about that and you grow through it, then you are more happy. Maybe sometimes they are very difficult things. Maybe sometimes they are the most challenging things. Sometimes you have to face that the worst memory of your life or your past life being burned on the fire as a witch, or some past memory from being abused or whatever, it's coming back to you as it is happening now, but because you know that now you are safe with the trusted partner, with the person who you love, who you feel to be loved, and you are able to always, you trust the person, so you're always able to say, hey, this goes too much, I want to slow down and whatever. And this ability to have control over what is happening and ability to feel that there is safety, there is trust, it gives you ability to grow through the wounds, what happened to you, to release these emotions what were frozen in the moment when you was maybe small and could not release them. You was maybe smaller than your oppressor and maybe getting angry would just provoke more violence, and so you had to froze this anger. But then and the same feelings, the same memory, it's coming like it is happening to you now, when, yes, there are trigger points touched by your partner, and then all the anger is released on that person and so. And yes, when we are aware about the process, then we can realize, okay, this is not about me. This is not only about my partner. This is not only about the presence, but it's not only also about the past and the future. So you, when this awareness, you can choose to release that anger and let it go completely, and not to react at this anger, and don't take it personally and let it go, and support each other in the process and so on. That's beautiful, being mirror to each other, being supportive to each other. That's what the conscious relationships are giving us, what you are not able to build up in one night stand or in some holiday relationship, because it's just doesn't go so deep. That's why we encourage you to go as for the as deepest connection as possible, as most then you become the mirror to each other. Not just playing another theater, playing another mask, just to comfort yourself in the moment. Well, it's nice at the beginning, but it's doesn't have the deep depth. I wanted to speak about Unhealthy ego and healthy ego things, what also are very connected, of course, with the conscious relationship, because yes, conscious relationship starts with a relationship with ourselves, first with our feminine, masculine, but also with our unhealthy ego, healthy ego, healthy mind, unhealthy mind, with our body, heart, mind and spirit. So there is a big crowd within us. Some people even say all universe is within us. So yes, like in a father, in a mother, and so on and so on. And yes, the path of Tantra is finding the harmony between these sometimes seem to be opposite sides, but actually they are all parts of you, and finding the harmony and connection there, and creating the inner friendship instead of inner fight and dominance. That's the one of the direction in Tantra. So and of course, if you create this harmony connection, that would reflect sooner also on your outside world. So sometimes the best way of working on the relationship is start to work on yourself and solving the issue within yourself. So yes, talking about ego and unhealthy ego. So yes, in many spiritualities you hear this very often. You have to kill your ego, you have to quieten your ego, you have to kill your mind, you have to quieten your mind, and so on and so on. In Tantra we say yes to everything, to each part of you. It's actually even the so-called negative emotions are very positive, because actually they are your friends if you are friends with them. And so like the emotions like anger, fear, would by many teachings are considered as some kind of negative. In Tantra we see them like, hey, they are emotions what can actually are natural to you to have them. And yes, if you don't suppress them, but in a healthy way allow them to be with you, they can be, they actually have their natural function in you to be there for you when it's needed. Anger, it can save your life in a dangerous situation, can protect you. And it doesn't have to be always violent. Sometimes, you know, like the Maori warriors used the haka, the dance full of anger expression. And in the end, sometimes it solved the bloodshed, because they showed their power instead of using their power over each other. And the other tribe felt like, okay, we don't mess with these guys. And so, yes. The anger with love, like the, you know, the mother of the wolf protecting her children. She used the anger full on, 1000%. She is in the anger to protect her children, you know, and it's out of love. If she would not use it, someone would not take her serious and would just kill her children, maybe without her being able to do nothing. But because she do it out of love, and she thankful that she can do that naturally, 1000%, not just like 80% or whatever, she can scare the oppressor away, make him feel, oh, we don't gonna mess. She have really something to protect. She not gonna give up. So, and she is strong, you know. So you can show the power through that emotions, if it's in natural way, if it's in healthy way, not suppressed and not overtaking you. It's really, yes, what we say, you transform your demons into your friends in Tantra. And that's what you do with anger. The same, the fear, it's your natural alarm system. It can save your life. It gives you Adrenaline, so you can run 300%, then maybe you would run normally, so you can think in 1000% of your capacity, you don't miss the split of the second when you are in the dangerous situation, when you are, not taken over by fear, but when you are friends with your fear, the fear may help you. But yes, if you are suppressing your fear, or you are living in the fear all the every day, getting the news from the TV about the like some dangerous situations and not being able to do anything or not even capable to do something, and then you start to you get the dose of fear all the time, and so then in the moment of dangerous everybody runs into the panic, and people, instead of thinking 1000%, they think like overtaken by fear, by panic, over exaggerated fear, and they think actually maybe 50%, and yeah, they do stupid things like running to one little entrance with thousands pushing each other instead of going in an organized way, and yes, have this capacity of thinking like beyond normal, even thinking, you know, so 1000%. Coming back to the subject of healthy ego and unhealthy ego, so yes, in Tantra we recognize that there is nothing wrong to have ego, and there is healthy ego. And I would say a beautiful example of a healthy ego, it's like Jesus, you know, like the man or the God who influenced the world in good ways, most of the people believe, and so. And yes, if he would not have a healthy ego, he would not be able to stand up in crowd of the people and tell them what they have to do, what they have to, what is the good way of thinking, and so on and so on. He have to have strong, healthy ego to be able to speak to the people like this, you know, to be able to influence them like this. What is the difference with the healthy ego and unhealthy ego? So unhealthy ego, it's the selfishness, narcissism in the extreme situation. And that's the ego what thinks just about me, myself, and nothing else is more important. And for myself, I don't care about anything else. I don't care about my partner, I don't care about my child, I don't care about that piece of meat that the hungry children have to suffer, that the animals have to suffer, that I'm contributing in the biggest way to the climate change and to deforestation and destruction of our planet. My appetite is more important. Yes, this is unhealthy ego. This is like the kind of, I don't call it love because it's blind selfishness. If you love yourself, if it's true love, unconditional love, you would realize sooner or later that you cannot love yourself fully if you don't love your partner fully and you don't love the others fully. As more love your partner, then you can love yourself much better. As love you more love your family, then you can love yourself better. That it circulates. So when you keep it stagnated, just me myself, it doesn't circulate. And this so-called love to yourself, it's actually gonna stagnate within yourself. And it's gonna start to stink. And what I'm talking about here, it's this. It will turn into the selfishness. It's you would think just about yourself. And yes, when you start to think about yourself only, then you separate yourself from all the others. So you start to think about like, oh yeah, you know, like I have to have this. I'm more important than, for example, my partner or even my child or whatever, my neighbor, whoever. And then you put yourself above It's not always wrong thing to put yourself above and so, but yes, you put yourself too much above, and then you do things what serve you, but sometimes they may hurt someone else. So yes, for example, I eat everything from the fridge, and my partner it's hungry. And yes, if I still have a little bit of consciousness, I would realize, my partner is now hungry, so do I feel good about that? And if I have love to my partner and love to myself, I would see maybe I have full belly, but I feel a little bit bad about myself that I didn't share that with my partner. So this is where you see that, you really need love to your partner to have love to yourself. When you share with your partner, maybe your belly is half full and not so, but you are proud of yourself, you feel good about yourself, you don't feel guilty about yourself. This love nourishes you much better sometimes than food, that's one example, and there are many, I could keep preaching because it's never too much. Yes, people very often choose their appetite, only appetite, actually it's even conditioning for the steak on your plate. This is more important that the children are dying from hunger because you can eat that steak. That the forestation, that the hundreds of animals have destroyed house, the jungle, the Amazon forest, the lungs of the earth are burned out, not even cut for paper, but burned out just to produce more soybeans for the farm animals to produce for you cheap meat, for to produce for you this steak, what you are choosing for. Of course, the suffering of the animals and so on, why your appetite is more important than their lives and so on. We could talk about the pollution of the earth, water, air, what is causing and what it's contributing more to climate change than anything else. All transport together, the meat industry. Choosing this just for your appetite, and not even for appetite, because you can get vegan steak, and I'm pretty sure that if I blindfolded you or you don't know nothing about that, you would say, it's pretty good steak if good cook prepare it and so for you, and you can eat every. Or a replacement of the meat now in vegan version, and so not even the appetite, just conditioning. Someone told you for many years that you have to eat meat, you have to have proteins. No, this is not true. There are vegans who are winning the muscular competitions. And they just eat the vegan proteins and so on. So yes, there is no reason for you to make that choice. Yes, it's your unhealthy ego. And yes, unhealthy ego want to find excuses, justifications, it's not true what I'm saying here. No, there is the doctor said that, and there are some other scientists. Yeah, but these other scientists, they also found the justification for themselves. So yes, of course, if you want to grow, you listen to those who you follow the path of love. And yes, if you look into the animal eye, would you kill that little piglet, or would you take away the cow child from her mother and things like that? If you would look into your heart and you would make the choices from love, you would choose for that, and then you, your healthy ego can grow, because you will be proud of yourself, oh, from making good choices. So always when you make the choices for nature, for others, for animals, for the humanity, when you choose the work that it serves the people instead of exploiting them, and so you feel good about yourself, and then you grow on it. So that's what it is, healthy ego. Healthy ego is about like loving yourself the way that other benefit from you loving yourself. Yes, so living in the way that it doesn't harm anyone else around, but it serve everyone else around. So that's the difference between the healthy ego and the unhealthy ego. Healthy ego, yes, doesn't need justification, because you don't need justification for like, hey, I'm working in this voluntary organization, what it's helping the victims of the wars, and you know, like, what justification you need for? No, you are proud of yourself. You can tell with proud to your parents, hey, that, this is the way why I'm choosing it above, like, maybe your previous work, working in the office and counting the numbers and so, and maybe have even more money, whatever. In your eyes, you see this is what your heart told you to do, and you're proud of yourself. You maybe some other people, maybe your parents would say, but you had more money when you work in the previous work. Yes, but you see, you could with the pride explain to your parents, you know what, but now I'm more happy. And that's what makes you, when you follow your healthy ego. So always check, is it your choice out of love or out of something else? Out of fear, maybe out of greed, maybe out of anger, you want to take revenge on someone or whatever. And whenever you feel that, yes, this is out of love, this is like, and it's not just love to myself, it's not like this selfish love, oh yeah, I'm gonna eat all the cookies and forget about my friends, yes? But it's out of love to, it's like actually I'm gonna bake more cookies, you know, like that I can share with everyone. I will find solution for everything. So it's, yeah, it serves your friends, your friendship, your maybe your family would enjoy the cookies, and you know, like for me, it's like nothing more beautiful, you know, like I'm like to play games, you know, like the chess or, you know, Monopoly and whatever, Catan, and you know, like I like, it's nice to win and things like that. But you know, when I love my daughter, when I start to play with her, and when I realize as much as I love to win, I love to lose with her, because I see her happiness when she is winning. It's actually my happiness. Realizing about this is making me like, wow, you know, like actually I don't have to win, you know, I can enjoy the person. If I'm connected with my daughter so much that I can feel her happiness when she is winning, I'm winning double, you know, because I'm winning more than I would win myself. So yes, this connection with others also brings us like, hey, you know, like, and that's what also, yeah, choosing for love always, it guides you into more connection, more feeling oneness with the others. So yes, yes, I always pride to say beautiful example when I see the happiness in my beloved eyes after love making, and knowing that I influenced that, that's the best moment in love making. It, no any cosmic orgasm can replace it. It's this, you know, that her happiness is my happiness, and it's like, wow, it's like heaven on earth. And thankful,
thank
my
you,
beloved,
I love you.
Thankful, my beloved, that I can experience it every day for a long time. And so it's like I love my life. I just love my life. So yes, and that's what it's like. Healthy ego, you know, like the way of love, like love making. What I know that it's like will serve, would nourish, would make happy my beloved one. I don't think about my goal like I used to do when I was addicted from sex and ejaculation, when I need to come and so. Now I feel like, no, it's like I just enjoy and my partner enjoy and we enjoy. So yes, we flow in it. And this love circulates in the same way how I explain. It's the same in the sexuality. If it you let it flow, you don't do it from your unhealthy ego, but with your healthy ego, out of love, not from out of need and desire only, but like just out of love, out of sharing and actually taking care for my goddess, worshiping her. This makes, you know, love making, not just sex, yeah? Love making, you make more love, yeah? So yes, so that's about the healthy and unhealthy ego in the sexuality as well. So yes, oh yes, and I wanted to speak about my unhealthy ego considering my coming soon birthday. And I had just, you know, usually when I wake up or I'm in after love making this time in very high frequencies, I don't lose the energy, I gain the energy, so this energy sometimes transform into inspiration, into some golden thoughts, I call them. So I had this kind of golden thought about, and I feel like, is it not too egocentric a bit, you know, like, I think, you know, like Jesus, he need a guts sometimes to speak out to, like, I don't know, the big Pharisees, you know, like the authority of the religion and so that, hey, you talk bullshit, you know, this is not what the God said and whatever, this is not what God feels or whatever. So it's like, yes, it feels for me now like if I have to say that, because it's like a bit like we are conditioned in the societies that we kind of like speaking about ourselves, celebrating my birthday, asking for like help or you know, for advice, it's seen very often as a kind of like selfishness or egocentric behavior and whatever. But I would like to like show here like, hey, look, you know, there are sometimes, you know, conditionings, what are conditioning us about to make us small, to make, to disempower us from feeling this healthy ego and using this healthy ego for maybe for us, of course, because it's for healthy ego, yes, so it's for us, but with the thinking about the others, with the choosing the others and so also and I feel, you know, like this is the unconditional love, when it's aligned, when your love to yourself, when your benefit to yourself, it's aligned with the benefit for especially your partner, but then also to the others, yes, if it's also like especially your partner benefit from your actions or your choices, but also the others may benefit from it. That's the law of flow, that the energy flows, it circulates, and so on. And if it's aligned, it's beautiful. If it's not aligned, it may be harm someone, or it, then, you know, you have to feel, okay, what way to choose. Sometimes we have to find the ways and or grow into the ways, and so, yes, because we are also conditioned to choose sometimes wrong, and so I would like to raise this awareness about this thing. I had idea. I would start with explaining myself, because I don't like to be taken wrongly. So myself, it's my life, it's very simple, you know, like I'm some people know me from rainbow gatherings, that I'm happy living for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, sometimes even, and teaching, living in the nature, in the tent, small tent, not big tent, just small tent, and almost every day sharing workshops, tantra, teaching, enjoying it, seeing how other people grow, how they benefit, and yes, sometimes I do it like rainbow gathering. It's like living in the nature, no civilization, no blinky blanky lights, beautiful music from the laptop, and so on and so on. There is no electricity. So yes, I create the temple in the nature, not on the nice wooden floor with the nice windows and things like that. But, you know, you create on the grass. Sometimes you are lucky that you found flat surface without, you don't chop the trees, so without trees in the middle, and so on and so on. And yeah, people who are coming to rainbow gatherings, also like everything is for free, so I don't make money, so everybody can enjoy the tantra, deep tantra. In the normal world, yes, we charge the money. In rainbow, people can experience, I'm sharing it for free. I don't make money, so I cannot, I come usually with some beautiful decoration things and so, like to make the place beautiful and so, but it's kind of minimalistic and so. And yes, it's like, you have a bit of sometimes discomfort of the weather. If it's raining, you know, like, yeah, we do the melting hack and the waterfall is just half meter dripping. I had this situation. And yes, people were, like comfortable with this, you know, because, you know, some of them, they used to do that. And the nature, it's a beautiful temple by itself, you know, like, So I don't mind, you know, like it's like I'm comfortable with this, what I have, and so. But with in the normal world, yes, I teach students, and yes, in the normal world, it's not that as on rainbow someone is cooking vegan food for me, because that's how it works. I do the workshops, maybe, and some people from their heart, not from their duty, preparing the meal for me. And so in a normal world, it's a bit different. I have to take care that, I have the place where I can teach. And in normal world, it's a bit different, everything. Yes, for everything you have to pay money. For the food you have to pay money. So you have to make money either. So if you have to make money, then you have to ask for the money. And if you ask for the money, people have standards, and they like to feel that you bring some good quality for that. I like that my students in normal world, they feel as best as possible. They have comfort that there is beautiful space, as much beautiful as possible, that you are not squeezed to each other, that you have nice comfortable mattress, and so. And people who know me closer, you can see that, you know, like, and know me also from the rainbows, that for me myself, I don't need extra super comforts and so. But yes, for my school, for my place, I love to invest in this, you know. So I love to create the most beautiful place, most comfortable. For my students, I love to have money, I love to invest. So yes, it's like people who knows me closely know that I'm not the vanity person who need like the most exclusive, expensive restaurant to show off myself. Hey, look where I'm eating,
like
and or you know, like have big Porsche, Cadillac to show off. Hey, look how most modern car I have, or most modern iPod or whatever. No, for me it's like I'm all minimalistic for myself, and so I'm a humble person. I feel myself as a humble person, but yes, I love to yes, that my beloved one feel comfort also, not just my students.
Thank you, darling.
Yes, that my daughter may come here to Thailand for holidays to see his father and enjoy life, and so there are some things what I love to, yes, for my closest one, but it's more for also for myself, and so.
She's got a beautiful okay,
and yes, what I would say, you know, like, oh, look, I start all this actually, you know, like you will see what follow, but I started from long explaining of myself. So this is already how, you know, in which conditionings I am, that I have to first explain myself before suggesting some, like, you know, hey, look, I want to ask you something. I want to offer you something, yes? So yes, I had this brilliant idea that for my birthday, yes, we do like beautiful party, like last year was very successful. I wish this year would be also beautiful. I offer one tantra workshop, a small tantra kriya yoga for all my friends and for everyone who want to come. You may come for my birthday, you're very welcome. And yes, there is after heart sharing, the fire, by the fire, that we have some a bit like tantric communication, a bit like for 1 hour. But beside of this, like, it's free program, maybe some people would contribute into the program and so on. We let it flow and so. Yes, so we will celebrate. So yes, this that I'm already celebrating, I'm seeing myself and celebrating it as a Facebook event, and as a, like, hey, look, I have birthday, you know, like, it's already there is like some conditioning of like, hey, hold back. In spirituality, you should hold your ego back. You should not shout about your birthday and whatever. Maybe you should celebrate more humble and things like that and so. But you know, like, that's what I want to say, like, hey, we should all celebrate our lives, you know. I love when someone invites me for the birthday, and I can celebrate with him, her, in the way how they like it and so. And for me, it's like, yes, occasion to connect, to meet each other. Like, you know, we used to do that, my family used to do that in Christmas or in the Easter, you know, gather together and so. So yes, we as a friends, you know, like, a bit more out of religion and traditions, we create, some of the traditions are very beautiful. And I feel celebrating of your friend's birthday, you know, like, in the way that, hey, whatever way, it's all beautiful. People come, people enjoy, people connect, people meet each other. It's all beautiful, you know, like, it's another occasion to celebrate life. And it's not particular about just my life. It's about like friendship all together, you know. I will see all my friends together. I don't see them every day all together, you know, like so. Yes, it's not just for me, but for all my friends to come together again, one occasion to like not to miss. So yes, but yes, so why not? Why you know, like there is some this voice in the like kind of like, I'm not saying it's nothing wrong with humbleness and so, but sometimes, you know, like it's good to have goods. And I'm not saying, you know, some people are not like me and they can be very beautiful and so. But like, you know, there was nothing wrong with Jesus that he, you know, like celebrate life as well, you know, when there was time to celebrating. So, and he shared his love through that celebrations and whatever. So yes, oh, now I hear the voice in my head. Oh, you compare yourself to Jesus. Oh, ego from here to Tokyo. Oh, how you dare, you know. Okay, yes. What idea came to me, like, that I want to offer in my birthday the kind of gift, but not gift. The gift is already, you know, like that my birthday celebration. Because honestly, you know, like, you have to have goods to celebrate your birthday publicly and invite your friends and invite your also not friends come to join your workshops, join your food, your life, and basically maybe becoming your friends, who knows, and so. You have to have goods because first you have to yes, step like you have to do something. You have to get out to the public, and it's you know, like I'm myself. Yes, I love to speak to my students. I love to speak to the camera. I love to organize things for the others, and so. But and some maybe I love to be sometimes in the center of the attention or whatever, but you know, not because I have some like excitement from this, no, because I have something to share. I have some love to share with you. I want to see my friends coming together and see them celebrating life together with me. I feel these moments of like friendship, like of being together, of like maybe, you know, like some of our friend was a bit alone for some time, and this occasion to come would take him out of like, oh, and then he meet thankful that another friend who would give him great advice for the problems what he is facing alone and things like that, you know. So it's like when I speak to my students, yes, I have to put myself into this kind of healthy ego teacher position, authoritarian, a bit like as a kind of leader, because I have something to share. And yes, now it's my time to share your time. You come here to learn something. When I come to your class, I would be a humble student and, you know, like the best of exchange of this, it would be like, okay, I better quiet. I don't, maybe I disagree with you, but I swallow whatever and I take whatever I want, but I don't distract what you want to share, because yes. You are the teacher, I'm the student at that moment. So yes, you know, like, of course, yes, there are question and answer moment that you can challenge your teacher even, and you can challenge me if I'm teacher and so. But there, yes, yeah, so there are moments where you put yourself into, and it's, you do it because you have something to share. You have some wisdom, some love to share. what will help the others to have more happy life and so on. That's what you believe. That's why you're teaching. That's why you're doing it. This is the main reason why I love to do it. Not the kind of excitement of, because actually, honestly, it's always a bit of challenge, you know? There is part of me when I start to teach and I see there like some challenging energies around, and maybe there is part of me who would like to just hide and, hey, why are you doing it? What? Why you put yourself in this, out of this comfort zone? And so it's the love. It's the love to the others. It's the, hey, you know, the effort of creating this event, this workshop, this retreat, this even birthday, it's an effort. And yes, it's an effort that, hey, you take a risk. Maybe some people would come, maybe some not, you know, and maybe and that's always, you know, like, you know, maybe it would, everybody would be happy, or maybe, you know, there would be some other event suddenly and everybody would go there, and then you would feel like, you know, like, oh, you know, like, and life is life, you know. And when you like, and maybe sometimes, oh, it would not go the way how you would love. Maybe last year was better, was so good, you know, then, you know, this year would not be so good. And you have to accept it. Yes, it's all, you know, like, it's all, you know, like, yes, a bit of out of comfort zone. So, but anyway, in coming back to the unhealthy ego and my offer and healthy ego, it's like in Dutch tradition, there is like habit, and I like it. When you have birthday, you give the gifts to the others. You normally, in Polish tradition, for example, and in most of the tradition, if you have a birthday, you are the one who is receiving the gifts. Yes? In Dutch tradition, there is still celebrated, like that you are actually giving like to the others small gifts and so. And of course, you receive the gifts as well. I like it very much that, you know, like when my daughter had a birthday in the crèche and then in the school. She had to give to all the children in the class a small gift. That was beautiful. I felt like, wow, that's kind of like different. And I like this tradition. So that's why, you know, like at my birthday, I want to offer at the party Tantra Kriya Yoga. And then I like to guide also the heart sharing and tantric communication by the fire. I want to also give something. But yes, I want to offer also for my birthday gift to you, but also to myself. I want to offer to all of you like the beautiful online courses, what we just created, the Tantra for Couples, a Tantra Massage course, got more parts, Brotherhood Corner, and that would support you in beautiful ways, and it would support the Tantra Movement School, so my students will have better comfort to enjoy their teachings. And yes, of course, a percentage would go to my beloved, because I love her so much. Okay, so much explanation to let it spit out at the end. So that's what I mean about these conditions. You choose what you like. Don't follow me, follow your heart. Use it, don't lose it. Love yourself, love your partner, love it all.